sisters in terms of da'wah, then as the scholars have said, as many of the scholars have mentioned, the default, the asl in giving da'wah is for the men. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made all of the prophets and messengers men. So the da'wah, going out onto the streets or going out into the masajid to hold lessons and doing other activities, maybe online, and these affairs, the default is that this is for the men. They are the ones who engage in those activities. That does not mean that the women cannot do anything. Of course they can. But if the sisters are doing activities, it needs to be done in a manner which is organized. If, for example, in Singapore now, there are going to be some sisters and they want to hold some sisters' gatherings, no problem. The sisters can come together, they can have some gatherings. But I do not see that there is any need for any sisters to start holding their own classes. Because it is better that the sisters, they come and they join in, they sit like in this telelink, as I am aware that there is a separate location where the sisters are gathering. This is good. When you have these telelinks, when you have these classes, arrange some space for the sisters to come together and they can listen to the class as well and allow their questions to be put forward too. Give them the opportunity to put their questions forward to the speaker, whoever it may be. This is how the sisters should get involved in the da'wah. I do not think it is a good idea for sisters to open up their own separate classes. That often causes problems. And the truth is, if you have these telelinks, you have these lectures going on, you have people teaching you, then it's enough for the sisters to come together and to gather in these types of lectures in their location and listen. There is no need for separate lessons. If the sisters want to just get together to improve the sisterhood, come together every now and again with the permission of their husbands, that is good, no problem. They can come together, maybe have some food together in the home of one of the brothers. In the homes of one of the brothers, maybe he can leave the home for the sisters one night. Something like that. They want to come together, they want to meet, they want to speak to improve the sisterhood, but not to do a dars, then that is okay. But doing the dars and doing the lectures and doing teaching, then that is only for people who are qualified. And it is not a need for a sisters to do that. They can sit in these lectures, they can attend these lectures, gather in their locations, and that is sufficient. So it is not something suitable for sisters to start opening up their own lectures or their own classes and their own gatherings separate to the brothers. I do not think that is a good idea for the da'wah purposes.